partnership, then depth of a partnership, finally the dissolution of the partnership. That is what till now we were studying about the partnership, purely about the non-profit organization and partnership company, partnership. Now today's class I am going to start part 2. Okay, from part 2 you are going to study the company's accounts. Okay, company's account, how company is going to be, how they are going to maintain an account. So first chapter, it's about the accounting for share capital. We know that in the previous year, last year only, you have studied under the sources of business finance and the business studies, where you had a owner's capital as well as borrowed capital. Owner's capitals are equity shares and preferential equity shares, correct? Then about that we have studied, correct? In today's class, in second year, part 2, you are going to study about the company's account, how the company's account are maintained. Okay. Coming to the chapter, accounting for share capital. What is capital? Capital is nothing but it's a have a definite face value, correct? Where the small units of the capital face value is together, it is called as a share, correct? Share. Now, and people, those who contribute the capital, they are called as a shareholders. So, here we have capital contributed by the large number of the person are called as shareholders. What is share? Share is nothing but the small units of the capital or the amount of brought together to totally, it is called as a, which has a definite face value, it is called as a share. Next. It's a company account. As I told, it's a company account. Company will have the dealings of shares, debentures, preferential shares, etc. Correct? So, the company can be described. What is company? We have studied what is company in the last class. In the previous year itself, we have studied company is nothing but which has a it's an artificial person. It is created just like that. It is. It does not have a they can't move from one place to another. So, that is why it is told as artificial person having a separate legal entity, perpetual succession and a common seal. You know it. It is not a new meaning for you people, because you have seen this meaning. You have already studied this meaning in the previous year. Correct? So, coming to the meaning, features of, I will just glance what you have studied. Same thing is similar to that, only it is there here also. That is why I just take it faster. Coming to the features of share company. First feature is, you can write what you have written in the meaning itself can be written as a feature. So, I have taken only four few features. You can also add artificial person, or you can take the risk factor or the some other point also you can add it here. So, coming to separate legal entity. What is separate legal entity? What is the meaning of entity? Entity is nothing but identification. So, in the joint stock company, first one is separate legal entity, which is separate from its owner. Owner is separate and the business is separate. Correct? Company as well as the owner is not same. It is separated from each other. Next, we have the perpetual succession. What is perpetual succession? Perpetual succession means, as I told, it's an artificial person. It does not have a one, you know, character like as a human being. Like, it cannot see, talk, walk, all that. So, it's just an artificial. Like, institution is an artificial, correct? Where it is just a building. Others will, you know, take care of it. That is why it is told it's an artificial person. Next, it is a perpetual succession. Perpetual succession means, people will come and go, but the business remains same. Means it is started under the law and it ends under the law. Okay. So, it does not have any, you know, means everything is under, it is taken care, everything is under the law. Legally it is done and people will come and go, but the building remains, but the business or the company remains same. Okay. Next, it is common seal. As I told, it's the artificial person. It is created. Correct? It is created. That is why it does not have, it can't, physical features are not there. That is what is public company and private company. Public company is a, which is not at all as private company, that is which it is called as a public company, correct? Where they have the rights, like they can sell, they can transfer their shares, and the members are unlimited here, and they can invite the public to issue the shares. All that is about the public company. Coming to private company, what is private company? It is a company which has a minimum of 2 members and the maximum is extended to 200 members, and they cannot invite the public to subscribe for shares, and they cannot transfer their shares from the correct? All that we have studied. I am just glancing, students. From this chapter, you will get only 2 or 1 mark theory questions. Okay, 2 or 1 mark theory question. You just need to know the meaning and some of the definitions. Okay. Next, you have the categories of share capital. We have the share capital. There are 3 categories of. There are many categories of share capital. One is authorized capital. Okay, authorized capital. What is authorized capital? See. MOA, Memorandum of Association of every company, has to specify the amount of capital with which it wants to be registered. Okay, that is why it is also called as a registered capital. In order to start, how much is required, overall capital, how much they want to register, that is called as authorized capital. Authorized capital is also called as a registered capital or the nominal capital. Okay, it's the main capital. How much the it mentioned in the Memorandum of Association, they have specified what amount they are going to register. Okay, usually it is a large amount. It will be a large amount. First, authorized capital. Next, we have the issued capital. Issued capital is a part of authorized capital. Everything is a part of the authorized capital. So, issued capital is a part of authorized capital which offered to the public to subscribe in the form of shares. Like, what is shares? We know that we, as a owner, or the if I want to start a company, company means it is not one people, it's a member, large number of the members it will be started. So what we will do, we will subscribe, we will give the opportunity to subscribe the shares of the company, to purchase the shares of the company and to get the money. That is what here issued capital means, which is offered to the public. How much we offer to the public to subscribe for our shares. Okay, that is called as issued capital. Issued capital means how much, in simple I can tell that how much public is going to purchase from our company. The shares, what the, how much we are, subscribing, like public will subscribe for shares in our company. Next it is subscribed capital. Okay, what is subscribed? For which the application money are received from the public. See, here we have some application, allotment, first call, first second and final call, all that you are going to study. What is that? See, first I want to start a company. Okay, alone I can't start a company, so I will collect the share money. Okay, from the public. Public will start the applying for the shares. So they will purchase the shares. I will get the money. Okay, from our company they will purchase the shares and we will get the money. So what we are going to start, in which amount we are registered, that is called as registered capital or authorized capital or nominal capital. Second, we have the issued capital. Issued capital means which the public has subscribed. For what rate, like how much the money it for shares public has asked for. Okay, public has asked for, that is subscribed capital. Next, issued capital. Subscribed means when we get the shares, we have to get, if we have to pay the share, give the shares, then we have to receive the money. So from the public. So which applications are received from the public, the amount for which we received the application. So subscribed capital is a part of issued capital. here they may call for 7 rupees, 8 rupees, whatever this number. That is called as called up capital. Next we have paid up capital.
Every time they get the fixed rate of dividend.
dividend, they get the fixed rate of dividend every year. Okay. So with this, next we'll move on to the next topic. Within 130 days,